Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to use Preview to merge two PDF documents. Now, this is a subject I've covered in the past, but Preview seems to change just a little bit with each version of OS X. So it's worth taking a look at how to do this using Preview in Mountain Lion. So here I've got two documents, A and B. They're both PDF documents, and I want to end up with a single document that has all the pages from both of these in there. So I want to preserve the original two. So the first thing I want to do is select the first document and I want to duplicate it in the Finder. And once I have that, I've got this copy now that's the same thing as document A. I'm going to rename it document A plus B. It still just has the contents of A in there. So the next thing I want to do is open it up in Preview and then bring the pages from document B into it. So if I double click, it will open up in Preview automatically. If it doesn't for you, you can always drag and drop it to Preview in the dock or Preview in your Applications folder, or Control click on it and select Open With and select Preview to open it. So now I've got document A plus B and it contains all the pages from document A. Now I can see the pages easily if I were to go into the toolbar here and select Thumbnails. You can also do that by going to View and switching from Content Only to Thumbnails. So now I see each page here on the left and I can scroll through it and I can see there's seven pages in this PDF document. And you can see up here there's this little reveal button here and I can just have the entire document as one thumbnail, or I can reveal all the different pages of it. Now I'm going to open document B. So I'm going to double click on it here and it opens up in a separate window. I can do the same thing here and look at the thumbnails, and I can switch between one or all the pages. So now I can move these documents side by side, and actually merging the two is pretty easy. Let me just combine them both like that, and all I need to do is grab the thumbnail here and drag and drop from one to the other. Now here's where it's very easy to get a bit mixed up, because I can drag this here to the bottom and what I get are two documents. You can see it has just basically put both windows into one window, and you can see this line here. So I have one document and another document and nothing has actually changed. The files are the same. I'm just able to view them in one window. That's not really what I wanted to do. So instead I want to make sure that I've revealed all the pages for this document and all the pages for this document like so, and I'm going to select all the pages. Select first one and then shift select the last one. Then I'm going to drag them into the second document. I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom here and you can see there's the line that divides documents. I'm going to drag here and instead of putting it down at the bottom, which will actually put it in its own document there, I'm going to move it up so it's right under the last page. You can see that plus, that green plus button that appears under the cursor, meaning it's going to add these to the document. So when I release, sure enough, there's page 6 and 7. I can see the two pages I've added are 8 and 9. It is a single document. I can collapse it there. That has all 9 pages, 7 from the first and 2 from the second. So it definitely is a bit tricky, the difference between dragging into the left sidebar and just having two documents open in that window, or dragging into the left sidebar and merging the pages in both PDF files into one file. So you might want to practice with it or just do some trial and error until you get it right. Now also note that using these thumbnails here on the left, you can move pages around. So for instance, if I wanted these two pages to be at the beginning of the document instead, I could select them both like that and then drag upwards and go through all these pages, and you can see it allows me to insert them. Like if I wanted to put them between pages 4 and 5, I just drop them there. So now I've got the first four pages of the first document and then two pages from the second document and now these. So you can use that technique to rearrange these pages any way you want. So you can not only merge PDF documents, but you can rearrange the pages in them. So you can also delete pages from document. You can select one and just simply hit the delete key and it removes it from the document. So you can see I only have 8 pages in there now. It's only one of those pages from the second document is present. This also comes in handy if you have, say, a bunch of different forms and a bunch of different PDF documents and you want somebody to fill it out. Instead of sending them all that stuff, you can basically create your own PDF document with exactly the pages that you want in there, nothing extra, and everything in the right order. Now a handy way to start a new document is to use copy and then create a new document from what's in the clipboard. So for instance, say I'm in this document here and I want to copy, say, the first page, the third page. I'm going to command click on it to grab the third page and the fifth page. I'm going to go edit and copy. Then I'm going to say file, new from clipboard, and you can see that it creates a new document that has the first, third, and fifth page here as 1, 2, and 3. Now you'd think you'd be able to copy more pages from here and then paste over to here, but in fact you can't. It doesn't work that way. But you can certainly drag and drop pages. So if I wanted to, say, take this page here, drag it over here, I can add it as another page there. Being careful not to actually just add it as another document below that line, but actually have that little green plus button so that I'm adding the page to this document here. That's just another way to start a new document in Preview, other than that duplicate function that I did using the Finder at the very beginning of the tutorial. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.